the postmaster for about 5 years. Then I retire on a 275-year pension. I can throw a postcard across the room and give you a terrible paper.
The race book is open and the horses are running at the inside track. Stop by and play.
There. Goodbye.
Day like this calls for a little haggis.
Shit, fine then.
Need something? Blood. But if you go back far enough, who's hunting and who's hiding starts to get real blurry. She was in the ER last night with a bruised coccyx. Now she won't use her bouncy ball. All right, so you got 4 fugitives in front of you, and what they're worth. The real nasty ones are worth more money, but the little shits are fewer and further between. Ideally, we gotta hand them over alive for the full payout, but mistakes happen, you know? At least Murph, Ma's boyfriend at the morgue, can handle the, messier ones. We'll still get paid, but it'll be a cut to the money, so best keep them wriggling. I'll update this database regularly with what I know. So just log on in and see who we got out there. All right, that one's a weird one. She's a serious businesswoman, a CEO. So obviously, she dodges everything that comes her way. Quarterly reviews, taxes, conspiracy to murder charges. And now, she's jumped bail by being, get this, dead. Honestly, people will try anything. Thank you.
I know Jeanette's got this under control, but I have a little insider information about the target. She's apparently dead. Now, I say that because my boyfriend, Murph, is a mortician and friends with the crew over at St. Fiacre. They said something's off about the body that came in. Jeanette will call in a second to give you the lowdown, but in the meantime, start heading over to the morgue.
Murph's friend that works in this morgue said the body should be in one of the cabinets.
Piece of shit.
If the world thinks Whitney is dead, then
You like my new hair? You look like a totally different person, right? Ugh. God, the general population is so stupid.
She still doesn't know that the jig is up. So get past the guards, then focus on her.
No! I'm gonna fucking kill you!
armed.
I need to reload.
I hope your mediocre bounty hunting business has a good legal team, because you've never been sued like I'm about to sue you. You'll all spend the rest of your days fighting for scraps at Bolingbroke. This dump will be shut down before the year is out.
Got your number, asshole.
Ah, shut up.
I cannot wait to see the headlines. Mrs. Grace Whitney, tennis death baloney. The Daily Globe should hire me.
Alright, I got this one just for you. Jumped bail during a grand larceny trial. Had a scam running a fake bank. Cleaned a few dozen decent folk out of their life savings. Must be a talker, cause he ain't a looker. But then again, Duggins never are.
I'm gonna lay you flat.
What's up?
You know the Duggins. They got that goon fund, and boy, do they spend it. When you get close, just you be ready. I'll be shook if he's all alone in there.
Hey, who the hell are you?
Get out!
You got any idea who you're pissing off? Stand down! I'm a fucking Marine! Dick! You fuck with the wrong soldier!
I'm gonna lay you flat. A real piece of work.
Once you've got our guy, bring him back for processing, nice and careful.
Cock-sucking piece of trash! cock-sucking piece of trash!
Go fuck yourself.
La la la, I'm not listening. Here's to the Duggins, keeping us busy.
Oh, okay. This is seriously fresh. Guy was in prison awaiting trial when he jumped the freaking bus. And he stole a regular bus, and let's not get into what happened to that, but if we're gonna get him, we need to get on it now.
The alert this morning. A goddamn real life Supermax prison break. Okay. I've sent you Kenzie's last location where he jumped the prison bus. We have to grab him before anyone else does.
Oh, heavy. Love the car. Idiot!
Asshole!
get out of this fucking pool. Let's get out. This bitch.
Once you got the target, bring him straight to bottom dollar.
Look, man, you got one last chance to let me out. Man, you got one last chance to let me out.
This isn't over, you know. Could you not? Came with that last job with the Moorhead Rides Again vibes. Nice work, detective.
Three words. Kang Pai, bank robber, ka-ching! Wait, is bank robber one or two? This is a nasty one. His signature is knocking the teeth out of bank customers' mouths. You know how expensive teeth are? Check this guy out. He's rolling in Duggan money. Still doesn't stop him committing insurance fraud. Burned down an apartment he was renting out. Burned the tenant's dog with it. Typical Duggan, if you ask me. That one's a piece of work. Assault, homicide. Got told by my contact that he's feisty. You know, the way a rabid bear might be considered feisty.
My bad.
I ain't going down to your level.
Let me out, asshole!
really knew how to handle yourself during a robbery, huh? I won't read into that.